Hello, Odooers, and welcome back. Now that I have my Helpdesk team set up, I can start receiving tickets from my customers. Of course, I can always manually create a ticket in Odoo whenever a customer contacts us directly. But I can also automate this process, which saves me a ton of time. Odoo has three channel options for automatic ticket creation: email alias, live chat, and website contact form. Since live chat is its own app, it deserves its own tutorials. So for today, we'll just be going over email alias and website forms. I'll also review the automatic closing and customer closing options today too. Giving my customers different ways to connect with my support team lets them feel in control and makes it easier for them to reach out when they're frustrated. These different channels also save me time by organizing all ticket requests into one system. It's a win-win situation. So let's dive in and see how it all works. The settings for each of the support channels are available in the Helpdesk team form. So let's jump into the Helpdesk app and let's click on the configuration menu and select Helpdesk Teams. And let's click on the support team and scroll down a bit to channels. I can always go in and turn these channels on or off if needed. For the first part of this flow, we're going to be working with the email alias. When a new team is created, Helpdesk automatically creates a new email alias and names it after the team. When a customer sends an email to this address, Odoo will automatically create a Helpdesk ticket for me. I'm also going to scroll down a bit, and under Help Center for the website form, let's confirm that this checkbox is checked as well. We're going to be using the website form in the second part of our flow. Now that we've made these changes, I want to show you what the email alias looks like in action. Okay, let's say I'm a customer with a question about my order. I can send an email to the support team's special email address. So I'm going to go ahead and paste the support team's email address over here. And I'm going to go ahead and add a quick subject and message. I'm going to be asking, where is my package? And I'll title it Angry Customer. And then I'm going to go ahead and click send. Okay, now let's say I'm a Helpdesk agent. I know, I look super different compared to the customer, but I swear it's a different person. Here in the back end, I can go to my support team's ticket page and see that Odoo created a ticket from the customer's email. So I'll jump into the Helpdesk app and click on the tickets button for the support team, and boom, we can see the ticket that we just submitted. The email subject line becomes the ticket's name, so we have a heads up about their issue right away. Odoo also automatically assigns a ticket number. When I click into the ticket, I can see the body of the email in the chatter. I can also see the automatic response the customer has received in the chatter as well, thanks to the email template I set on the new stage of my pipeline. I can also use the chatter to send messages to the customer and log internal notes for myself. Back over here, I can use the stars to set the priority level for the ticket. I'm going to go ahead and set it to 3 stars. I can also choose the tag to add any necessary information. Let's go ahead and tag this ticket as service. Simple, right? But setting an email alias isn't our only channel option. Customers can also contact us by submitting a request on our website. Okay, now I'm in customer mode, and this time I'm Jane, and I have a broken chair. I can go ahead and go to the company's website help page to submit a ticket. When setting up a form on a website, your company can choose what field you want your visitors to fill out. The fields marked with an asterisk are required, so right now I'm going to need to fill out my name, email, and subject. Since I'm already logged into my account, my name and email automatically populate for me, so I just need to add in a subject, which I'm going to type in as broken chair. And for the description, I'm going to fill it out as my chair leg fell off. How depressing. I can also choose to attach a file if needed. Okay, let's go ahead and submit this. And you can see that Odoo automatically gives me a ticket number. I can click on the number to view my ticket, or since this customer already has an account with my company, I can click into my account details on the top right to view my ticket in the customer portal. So let's go ahead and click on this and click my account, and let's click on the ticket icon and then the ticket number. And then let's head to the customer portal and ticket page. This page shows the ticket and any messages from the Helpdesk agent in the e-communication history and the ticket state. Now I'm back in Odoo as a Helpdesk agent. Here in the back end, we can see that Odoo automatically created a Helpdesk ticket from the website form submission. The ticket will have the same format as the one created through the email alias channel, except this time the customer's description of the issue will only appear in the ticket's description tab and not the chatter. As I work through the ticket, I can move it through the stages in the progress bar. Let's go ahead and move it to in progress. I can also update this ticket status by clicking on this little circle over here. Once the ticket is solved, I can go ahead and move it to the solve stage. Since the solve stage is a folded stage, any tickets in that stage are considered closed. Additionally, once a ticket is in the solve stage, Odoo automatically marks it as done and closes the ticket for me. However, I can also activate settings that allow customers to close their own tickets themselves from the customer portal, or allow Odoo to close tickets after a certain period of inactivity. For that, I have to go to the Helpdesk Teams form to activate some settings. So let's go to the configuration subheading and click on the Helpdesk Teams and click on the support team. From here, I'll scroll down to the self-service section at the bottom where I can activate the closure by customers option. This feature allows customers to close their own tickets on the customer portal of the website. I can also activate the automatic closing option. For the move to stage that appears, I want to make sure I have the closing stage selected, so in this case, I'll keep it as my solve stage. In the after field, I can specify the number of inactive days. Let's go ahead and change it to 10. In the stages field, I can click on the drop-down menu and select which stages Odoo will look through for inactive tickets. If I leave it blank, Odoo can close inactive tickets from any stage. Sometimes customers find the answers to their questions after they submit a support ticket. The automatic closing and closure by customers feature help us close those tickets, freeing up time to focus on other issues and keeping our pipeline neat and tidy. Today, we saw two channel options, email alias and website form, both of which automatically create helpdesk tickets in Odoo. We also learned how to activate automatic closing and closure by customers feature to better organize the ticket pipeline. When a customer needs support, I want to make sure the process is easy by giving them multiple channels to contact me and provide them with the power to close their own tickets. Stay tuned for more tutorials about Helpdesk. I'll see you in the next one.